Welcome at Octopus. With the increasing numbers of EcoTank printers being in the market, we also receive more questions about how the manual cleaning of the printhead can be done at such an Epson printer. We have put some thoughts into this. Our test printer is an Epson EcoTank L355, an early and simple EcoTank series model without a replaceable waste ink container. Typical for the EcoTank printers is that the inks are supplied from big tanks, which are filled from bottles. The inks flow through flexible tubes laying inside the printer, leading to the moving printhead compartment. Cleaning the printhead manually provides a simple opportunity to extend the lifespan of an EcoTank printer model that does not have a replaceable waste ink container. The manual cleaning procedure is done while the moving printhead compartment is positioned in the middle of the working area. To be able to position the printhead compartment, we switch on the printer and disconnect the power cable when the printhead has started to move. Without power supply, you can push the printhead from side to side by hand. The free-moving part of the ink line is protected by a plastic cover. Its purpose is to prevent the ink tubes from scrubbing on other printer parts. To get access to the ink tubes, we remove that plastic cover. We do that carefully because we want to install it again later on. Next, we detach the ink tubes out of the holder on the printhead compartment. They are held down there by little plastic hooks. Thanks to the soft material, the tubes can get pulled out one after the other. Each of the ink tubes is connected to a cartridge body, who is installed in the inkhead compartment. The cartridge bodies have a plastic bridge at their back. Below this bridge, there is a retaining nose that fixes the cartridge into its place inside the printhead compartment. Camera-wise, we have not been able to capture it in a better way. By pushing on the retaining nose from behind, using for example a screwdriver or your finger, you can unhook the retaining nose and set each cartridge body free in the printhead compartment. We encourage you to try which way to free the cartridges works best for you. Please take your time and use the necessary caution for unhooking the cartridge bodies, so you avoid unnecessary damages and spending time for sourcing spare parts. When the holding mechanism of all cartridges has been unhooked, the whole package of cartridges can be lifted out of the printhead compartment. If the connection from the ink tubes to the printhead is always done by such cartridge bodies as a type of bridge, this we cannot say for sure for all Epson EcoTank models. During the cleaning procedure, we place the whole bundle of cartridges in front of the printhead's working area. Now, as it is empty, we can take a closer look into the printhead compartment. It appears that it is actually regular Epson technology. For each ink color, there is a thorn in the bottom plate, which works as the entrance port for the ink into the printhead. To protect the insides of our printer from getting stained during the cleaning process, we install a combination of plastic material and on top of that folded kitchen towel below the printhead's nozzle plate. First, we install the foil material. It is simply laid into the way that the printhead travels along, and then it is pushed through under it from the left to the right. As the second layer, the absorbent paper material is to be brought in. We push the folded kitchen towel under the nozzle plate through. The previously installed foil material actually helps, as the paper slides on it quite easily. Positioning the printhead in the middle of the working area makes sure that there is sufficient absorbent material available to take in the mix of cleaner and ink coming from the nozzle plate. Our suggested way of cleaning the EcoTank's printhead manually is to flush the printhead from the ink ports to the nozzles in the nozzle plate by using a suitable hose and the printhead cleaning fluid for water-based printer inks. Our Octopus Fluids printhead cleaner is such a suitable cleaning solution. It is perfect to work on the Epson EcoTank's printheads. Furthermore, we use a refill syringe that has a lure lock connector and a hose, which has the matching lure lock piece on one end and whose inner diameter fits to the ink ports in the printhead compartment. The advantage of a lure lock connection between syringe and hose is that during cleaning the hose cannot slip off the syringe tip. Connection between hose and syringe has been made, and we have taken cleaning fluid into the syringe out of the bottle. Please pay attention to not pushing air into the printhead. In case there are air bubbles trapped in the hose, you can squeeze the hose and press this air upwards into the syringe. Now the actual cleaning, or rather flushing, of the printhead starts. Repeatedly push the syringe plunger 2 to 3 cm into the syringe and then release it again. The air in the syringe works as a buffer. It is compressed when the plunger is pushed in, and it expands after releasing the plunger. The pressure towards the printhead builds up very gently this way. The progress and the success of the cleaning you can see by the falling cleaner level inside the syringe, and also next to the printhead compartment, where the mixture of cleaner plus ink that is coming from the printer nozzles is absorbed into the paper material below the nozzle plate. Please clean the inside of the printhead compartment after removing the hose from the ink port. When you are done with cleaning, remove the absorbent paper material and the plastic sheet. In case you are going to clean more than one ink color, we recommend to change the paper material after each cleaned color. Now it is time to install the cartridge bodies back into the printhead compartment. Positioning the compartment at the recess in the rear section makes the installation more easy. For us, it turned out to be the best way to set the cartridges back into the compartment all together at once. Make sure that the ink tubes are not twisted. Doing so also helps that each cartridge will be set into the right slot inside the printhead compartment. The cartridge bodies are clicked into their position by pressing on the body's rear part. Again, please take a look that the ink tubes do not have a twist. Now we fix the flexible ink tubes under the retaining nozzles on the holder at the printhead compartment. Thanks to their flexible material, you can press each tube under the holding nozzles easily. Pay attention to that every tube has sufficient material between retaining nose and cartridge body. The tubes should not be under tension in that area. The following task is to attach the plastic cover above the tubes again. To fix the cover, there are three retaining nozzles on the holder at the printhead compartment. Just be patient. It also took us more than one attempt that every opening in the plastic cover finally met its holding nose. For the final fit of the cover on the holder, the whole plastic cover is pulled to the left, so it slides under the holder's noses. At this point, we are at the end of the manual cleaning process of the Epson ECOTANK printer's printhead. We make sure that the cartridge bodies sit in their slots properly and check that the ink tubes do not have a twist on their way from the ink tanks to the printhead compartment. After restoring the power supply on the machine and switching it on, the printer prepares itself to be in ready for printing mode. That may take some time. We close the printer's upper lid, as it is not necessary to see the insides at that point anymore. When you are going to start print jobs after the cleaning, we recommend that you do some test prints at the beginning. This makes sure that remaining cleaner fluid is printed out from the printhead. Thank you very much for your time, and thank you very much for your attention. We hope that our tutorial provides some useful information to you. We are looking forward to your comments and questions. Maybe we can say hello to you again at another Octopus TV session.